Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. Today we're going to be testing out a lot of Honest Beauty products. I've got some skincare and some makeup that I'm really excited to go ahead and test out. So let's go ahead and get started. All right, I'm in my bathroom. I've got my bunny or mouse ears on, whatever they are. My hair is back and I'm ready to test out the Prime and Perfect mask. Let's give it a squeeze. Oh, it smells so good. I don't normally like perfume and skincare, but this is so good. It's actually really pretty. Like, it looks really pretty. It smells really good. I'm showing you this little dollop on my finger. I don't know if you can actually see it. I want to say it smells like strawberries, but I'm not committed to that answer yet. When I was little, my mom would put masks on her face and I would always hide because I would be so scared of being scared when she comes out, because I did not know like if she would come out looking crazy, and I would just get like so scared of it. So I feel a little bit like my mom now, putting the mask on my face and then seeing what I look like after, because I mean, hello. It actually feels really nice on the skin. It's not like wet. It's not really too drying. It feels a little tightening. The worst part for me when applying a face mask, honestly, is washing it off. I hate that part. I don't like washing masks off. The application isn't so bad, but the washing of the mask, that is the part that I dread. All right, I am looking rather fabulous. I have washed the mask off. I'm gonna just dry my face really quickly. I'm gonna put my towel down. I don't know why I'm like clenching it. My skin is looking a little bit better. My favorite thing is that it's looking healthier but not shiny, because sometimes I feel like some masks can leave your skin either dry, which my skin is not drier now, it's not red or anything, and it's not oily either, but I feel like it's actually feeling and looking a little bit healthier. For me, this is the perfect kind of a quick mask that I can, you know, do in the morning, and it's part of like my self-care routine where I feel like I'm doing something good for my skin and my skin is a little bit better afterwards. So I would say this is definitely worth a try if you're into something like this. It's probably like a love at first smell for me. This has nothing to do with anything, but I just wanted to document my brunch. I'm very proud of it. Well, I've got an update for you on how my brunch is going. I was putting honey on the pancake and I dropped it in the bowl. I mean, the plate, whatever. Does anyone experience this kind of stuff, or is it just me? Because I mean, like, honestly, who does this? Who drops honey in the food? Now I have to go clean it up. All right, so I've set up my makeup station. So now we're gonna go ahead and start with makeup. So first I'm gonna try the hydration mist with a blend of aloe and watermelon extract. Close your eyes and spray directly onto face and neck, under or over makeup, and through the day as needed. I'm going to try to use it underneath my makeup first, just in case it's too oily, honestly, because my skin is very oily. So I just wanna make sure that it's not something that will ruin my makeup, essentially. I'm gonna roll back for a second because my tea is right over there and I don't want this to get into my tea. Ooh, it's quite a strong spray and it smells herbally, which I like. I'm going to blend some of the little droplets that I think are looking a little bit oily. I mean, this is something I can see myself using for sure, just because it's not overly strong in perfume. The spray, the actual mechanical spray part, works really well. And then the finish is nice. It's not overly dewy, but it definitely is there. So if you're someone who wants just a very mild, dewy kind of a spray, then this is definitely something that I can see working for you. Next, I'm gonna try this. This is Honest Beauty Magic Beauty Balm. I have not used it so far because I wanted to get this shot right here coming up. No fingerprints, nothing. Now, this is not just meant for lips, but that's what I'm going to be using this on. It's quite oily. Not in a bad way. I kind of said it like it was a bad thing. It's not. It's just, I pictured it being a little bit more heavy, a little bit thicker. It's actually, I mean, the balm itself is thick, but it melts with warmth of my finger. So far, I kind of like this too, but I will have to give it a try. And by that, I mean, I'll just give you an update later on in the day, whether or not this works. It's nice to apply it though. Like, I enjoy the actual application process and I definitely enjoy the packaging. It is so extra and I love it. I am also going to rub a little bit of this in my cuticles. My skin is not doing too good at the moment, but I'm not really gonna do a super heavy layer of makeup today, just because, you know, I feel like for Honest Beauty, I don't want to have like a cakey face because it's just not how, it's just not the vibe here, you know. We're moving on to cream blush. I'm both excited and nervous to try this out because I have only had like one cream blush in my life and that just did not work for me. I've had a bad experience. So, ooh, it's a pretty color. Okay, let me just show you the packaging really quick. Okay, there we go. Packaging for cream blush. Let me go ahead and open it. My color is called Rose Pink and it's beautiful. It smells nice too. Everything smells pretty good. I don't know why that matters to me, but it's just, I guess it's the experience of applying it maybe. All right, let's see how it does. It's quite sticky. I mean, I kind of like it. Tacky, not sticky tacky, but it's not like greasy. Like, it, you know what I mean? Like it settles into your skin and it kind of like stays in place. I was gonna do one blush on one side, one on the other, but I actually wanna go outside today and not scare people off with like completely crazy makeup on either side. So what I'm gonna do is I'm actually going to apply cream blush on both sides and then I'm going to come back with a different powder blush and just go over this one on top. So next I have a Luminizing Glow Powder in the color Dusk Reflection. It's probably meant to be like a finishing powder, but I actually got a darker color because I want this to be more of a bronzing kind of a powder. So let me show you what it looks like here. All right, so I'm going to take my trusty bronzer brush, which I desperately need to clean. Maybe I'll do that today. It has a really pretty finish though. You can see I applied some on my nose and my nose is shiny, but not greasy looking and not glittery. I love this kind of a finish. This is like my favorite. My skin's got texture at the moment and some dryness that I'm working through. So I may not want the reflection on my skin today, but when my skin is better, I think I will really, really appreciate having this beautiful kind of like sheen to the skin. Okay, now we're gonna try the powder blush. This is called Lit Powder Blush and the color is Flirty. Hello. Let me show you the packaging really quickly. It's all kind of similar. It feels very like loosely pressed almost. Like it feels kind of creamy, but also dry and it feels like it's gonna crumble a little bit. But it has a really pretty sheen. There's definitely a lot of dewy products in here, like in the collection now that I'm thinking about it, a lot of moisturizing, a lot of dewy products, like the good kind of dewy, like they got it right. Some dewy products are just, it's like, ooh, too much, too much. I kind of like it. It's dusty. That's my only like downside to this. If you tap the excess, it's fine. And the color is really, really pretty. Flirty is a really pretty color. What else do I have left to try? What else do I have left for my makeup is the question. This is the mascara that I'm gonna try right now. So this mascara, which also has really cute packaging, has two sides and it's really highly rated, so I have high hopes for it. It's got the lash primer side with the peachy end and then it's got the mascara side. And what got me kind of confused is that the lash primer comes out like this, right? But the mascara, I would expect the mascara wand to be on this side, but actually the mascara wand is here. So first you have to put the lash primer on. Ooh, I feel like some snow just fell on my lashes. I feel like I just got lash extensions. I think once the mascara goes over them, it's really gonna show, hopefully. I think I might be applying a little bit too much mascara. I'm not too sure though. I feel like with mascara, it's more is more, you know? The more the better. Yeah, I kind of look like I've just put on false eyelashes. I just thought I smeared mascara all over my face. Whew. That happened to me before, it's the worst thing ever. Not in the scheme of life, but when it comes to makeup, it's pretty bad. I mean, this is an intense kind of mascara and it is kind of clumpy as well. It really thickens your lashes, it lengthens them, but it will make your lashes kind of clumpy. If you like a fluffier look, still intense but fluffier, this is probably not gonna give you that. Battery has been changed. We are ready to move on to lips. First, I think I'm going to give this Honest Beauty Tinted Lip Balm a try. And my color is Likey Fruit. How do you say that? I probably should look it up. Let's see how you say it. I feel embarrassed for not knowing how to pronounce it. And I also don't even know what it looks like. But I guess it looks something like the color here. Lychee. Lychee. Wow. I was so off. It's called Lychee Fruit. If you're wondering what it looks like, let me find a good picture. If you're curious, this is what it looks like. It's nice and creamy. This one actually feels like a lip balm. Like if I didn't know it had color on it, I just would think it was a regular lip balm. It's that good. So I'm going to take this off just because I'm impatient and I want to try the other product. It actually has a good amount of color to it, so that's good. So the other product I want to try really quickly just to see how it applies and all that is this Off-Duty Liquid Lipstick. Okay, there we go. So this is what it looks like. It's a really pretty color. And let's see how this smells. This doesn't really smell like anything good per se. It just smells like product, but no worries. Oh, it's a pretty color. Just from the smell of it, I feel like it's a matte lipstick. Just the smell is like all matte lipsticks that are liquid lipsticks, I feel like have a similar smell. I'm not a fan of the smell. It doesn't have a nice like smell to it. It feels quite comfortable on the lips. I'm not a fan of matte lipsticks, but somehow I always end up trying them because I'm trying to find one I really, really enjoy. I don't know if it's just still drying, but it definitely has a sheen to it. But my wrinkly lips are not any less wrinkly looking. The pluses of this lipstick is that it is really comfortable and it's not drying. It's not like super matte, like the kind of matte that looks unnatural and dehydrating even to look at it. My only concern is it's collecting in my lip lines and it also kind of accentuates my lip lines. But again, that could just be me because I have trouble with matte lipsticks and I think this is one of the better ones out there. Now I can take my little clippies off. So what I think I'm going to do is actually I'm going to swap the lipstick for the lip balm because I feel like the lipstick is not going to work for me. And it's such a shame because I love the color. I think it's such a pretty color, but I just think that for my lips specifically it does not work. But I do think that if you normally like matte lipsticks and you don't have issues with them collecting in your lip lines like I do with every single one out there pretty much, then this might be a really good lipstick to try. All right, I'm back with an update. Everything is holding up pretty well. The blush is still on and I love the blush. I was actually thinking to myself that it really makes me look healthy. The mascara is great. The powder is really, really nice as well. But yeah, overall, I'm really, really enjoying everything. Most everything except for that one lipstick that kind of didn't work for me. Okay, I'm back with my last little bit here and I have two products. I don't know, I'm holding up three fingers, two products to share with you. So the first one is this Honest Beauty Gentle Gel Cleanser. I am halfway through using it because I have actually been using it for some time. I really like this cleanser. It's a very kind of gentle, mild cleanser. It doesn't have anything extreme to it. So if you have very oily skin and need something stronger or maybe like anti-acne like I sometimes do, this doesn't really have that necessarily. And on the contrary, if you have, or on the other hand, if you have very dry skin and you need something super moisturizing, then this may not be it. But if you have something in between, like a normal skin type, then this is probably gonna be something good to use to wash your face with. I don't know why I said that's so weird. It has kind of like a nice herbal scent. My only small like downside to this cleanser is that it's a foaming cleanser. And I have nothing against foaming cleansers except that this specific one, maybe because it's the face, it tends to get like a little bit messy and it can get in the eyes and in the hairline just because of the foam. And the last product I have here to try is this Honest Hydrogel Cream. Go. It's a very, very luxurious looking packaging. Cream, by the way, is pretty highly rated as far as I could tell, and it's got two types of hyaluronic acid, I believe. It suggests that you massage this in because that way it helps to burst the water. So, I mean, it is a little bit heavier than what I normally go for. However, my skin has been dry, so maybe I should be going for something a little bit heavier. So overall, I think this is a really nice nighttime cream. This is, again, my first time trying this just from the feel of it. It feels quite heavy. I want to say oily maybe even. And again, if you have acne-prone skin, just be a little bit careful because anything that's heavier can be problematic.
All right, guys, my camera has died, so I'm filming this last bit on my phone. Anyway, I really like it. It's just not what I thought it would be from reading hyaluronic acid and hydrogel cream. Anyway, on that note, I'm going to end this video. I hope you are having a wonderful day, morning, evening, whenever you're watching this, and I hope to see you guys in the next video. Bye.